게임인지도 모르는데 먼저 하는 건 위험해. 뒷번호에 줄다리기 때처럼 앞에 상황을 보고 작전을 짤 수도 있잖아.
Welcome to Watch Mojo. And today we're counting down our picks for the top 10 smartest decisions in Squid Game.
내가 삼각형으로 갈게.
그럼 거기는?
For this list, we're looking at the most clever, cunning, and cutthroat choices that kept characters in the series breathing for at least a little while longer. If you haven't seen these violent games yet, beware of major spoilers ahead. Which smart decision impressed you the most? Let us know in the comments. Number 10, standing behind players.
무궁화 꽃이 피었습니다를 외치는 동안 전진할 수 있으며 이후에 움직임이 감지되면 탈락입니다.
The twisted games begin with the most intense session of red light, green light ever put on screen. Players learn pretty quickly that if a creepy robot lady sees you moving when you're not supposed to, you will be violently eliminated. Fortunately, Sang-woo and Se-byeok realize that they can't be seen if they stand behind another person.
내 생각에 저인형이 동작 감지 장치야. 앞 사람 등 뒤에 숨으면 감지되지 않아.
This strategy allows both of them to move up in the game with ease. Gi-eun also uses this tip to get ahead too. Without this simple yet reliable strategy, a few of our favorite players may not have made it past the first game. Number 9. Forming alliances early.
우리끼리 한번 뭉쳐서 해보는 건 어때?
맞아. 앞으로 무슨 게임을 하게 될지도 모르고 여러 가지 경우를 대비해서 그룹을 형성하는 게 유리할 거야.
Although the majority of players came into the competition solo, teamwork became vital as the series continued. A few people were smart enough to seek refuge in numbers as soon as they could. The savvy gangster Duk-soo formed an evil alliance of rough characters that were mostly loyal and were willing to do practically anything to stay alive.
내 밑으로 들어와. 원래 우리 한 팀으로 꽤 괜찮았잖아. 응?
아직도 어제냐?
However, Gi-eun knew how to maintain the strongest team. Instead of going for pure muscle, he formed an alliance that had the perfect blend of brains, experience, and resourcefulness to work together for multiple challenges. Gi-eun's sharp team-building skills cannot be underestimated.
투자에도 그런 말이 있어. 계란을 한 바구니에 담지 마라.
Number 8. Player 17 both hides and uses his glass-making knowledge.
참가자들은 앞에 놓인 한 쌍의 유리 중에 어느 쪽이 강화 유리인지를 판단해서 그것들을 받고 18쌍의 다리를 지나.
During the fifth challenge, the participants had to make it across a bridge that contained tempered or easily breakable glass. Since the panels looked identical, it seemed impossible to tell where it was safe to step. But Player 17 had a huge advantage. Since he had decades of glassmaking experience, he could tell the glass apart.
다른 사람은 볼 수 없지만 강화 유리는 비스듬한 각도로 빛에 비춰보면은 희미하게 얼룩 같은 게 보여요.
Player 17 was so good that he could even distinguish where it was okay to leap to based on sound alone. And to top it all off, he was wise enough to hide his knowledge as long as he could to eliminate the competition.
처음부터 당신이 앞장섰으면
내가 왜요? 기회만 있으면 날 죽이려던 인간들인데.
If Player 17 had just been a little more confident in his expertise and not hesitated at the end, he might have survived. Number 7. Voting to end the game. Once it became clear that wearing a green jumpsuit could lead to an early demise, many people understandably started panicking. Fortunately, Sang-woo was able to put many of his fellow players at ease by reminding them they have an easy way out.
동의서 제3항! 참가자 과반수가 동의를 하면 게임은 중단된다. 맞습니까?
His accurate memory of the rules leads to the contestants holding a very close vote that seemingly brings the games to an end. Although many players decide to play again, the democratic solution was still a smart move. There were a few people that were okay with walking away from the gruesome competition and taking their chances in the real world. While those lucky few might not have easy lives, at least they can live to tell this tragic tale.
많이들 돌아왔니?
그러게요.
Number 6. Fighting dirty.
Among all the games that kids played back then, it was the most physical and violent.
So any kind of violence is allowed?
Sure. There are no restrictions.
Former friends Gi-eun and Sang-woo are forced into one last face-off in the finale. After picking the right shape in a coin toss, Gi-eun chooses to play offense in a high-stakes squid game. Since he has to get past his ruthless and extremely desperate friend, he makes a vital preparation. Gi-eun goes to tie his shoes while secretly grabbing dirt to throw at Sang-woo's face right away. This strategy allows the offensive player to save his strength for the much more important fight later on.
아메 화사. 아메 화사라고 했어.
During the climactic clash, a cornered Gi-eun lets himself get injured and bites and punches his way out of a tight spot. While it wasn't the cleanest way to win, his tactics eventually led to a somber victory.
우승 축하합니다. 대단한 경기였습니다.
Number 5. Jun-ho constantly changes masks.
저 해멀미 때문에 규칙을 잊었나?
Detective Hwang Jun-ho had to continuously improvise clever ways to stay ahead of the shadowy figures behind the games. His most brilliant decisions revolved around how he kept his identity a secret.
죄송합니다. 착각했습니다. 게임이 끝날 때까지 여기서 대기해.
After his cover is nearly blown, Jun-ho trades in his circular mask for one with a square symbol instead. His new covering grants him additional privileges and slightly more freedom to move around. But Jun-ho also keeps and utilizes the circular mask to blend in with certain workers and uncover more dark secrets. Although the constant switching isn't a foolproof plan, it does keep the detective from meeting certain deaths several times. Jun-ho's opponents were never truly sure what mask he'd sneak around in next.
교대 시간이야.
Number 4. Heating up the honeycomb needle.
선택하신 모양은 여러분이 뽑아야 할 모양입니다.
One of the most suspenseful tasks came when people had to get a shape out of a honeycomb without cracking it. We have to give a lot of credit to Gi-eun for making the unconventional yet brainy choice to lick the sweet treat to make the challenge easier. However, Min-yo came up with an even more brilliant strategy. After smuggling a lighter into the competition, she secretly used it to heat up her needle. Once she was done using the hot item to complete the tense task in a safe manner, she's savvy enough to hand her lighter to Duk-soo. So, not only did Min-yo's lighter get her through a game, it also helped her form a temporary alliance with the most intimidating player.
Bingo. 오빠 센스 있네.
Number 3. Betraying Ali.
가자. 그럼 형이랑 나랑 한 명 죽어요.
그럼 이렇게 넋 놓고 있다가 둘이 같이 죽을까?
If the frontman handed out awards for nicest person, Ali probably would have gotten a gold medal. Unfortunately, his nice personality led to his downfall when he played marbles against his constant ally Sang-woo. When Ali was on the verge of winning a deadly game of marbles, his friend/opponent convinced him to stop playing. Sang-woo insisted there was an extremely complex and guaranteed way that they can both get out of this deadly challenge alive.
지금 시간 없으니까 빨리 흩어져서 다른 팀들 상황을 좀 살펴보자.
While most players probably would have declined, Ali is gullible enough to believe in his friend's plan. Sang-woo is able to steal all the marbles and leave the nice man with nothing but rocks. It's a plan that was every bit as cruel as it was clever.
형! 상우 형! 나 보고 왔어요! 형!
Number 2. Pretending to be asleep.
전번에도 네 말만 믿고 돈을 보냈어. 내 목숨 걸고 구한 돈이었어.
Se-byeok decides not to return to the games empty-handed. Since she knew the organizers rendered the competitors unconscious with gas on the car ride there, she wisely covered her face. This move allows Se-byeok to pretend to be knocked out and smuggle a knife into this competition. She later goes on to use this sharp tool to sneak into a vent and get vital intel about the second game in advance. Although Se-byeok doesn't figure out everything, she gives the information to Sang-woo and follows his lead.
본 거 말해주면 내가 뭔지 알아낼 수도 있어요.
설탕을 녹이고 있었어.
And if all that wasn't enough, she also uses the knife to defend herself during a chaotic fight. Se-byeok's smart move to avoid sleep made her a cut above the rest of her opponents.
뭐냐? 나랑 하자.
Before we continue, be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos. You have the option to be notified for occasional videos or all of them. If you're on your phone, make sure you go into your settings and switch on notifications. Number 1. Taking 3 steps to victory. Since Gi-eun and Sang-woo's tug-of-war alliance wasn't full of the physically strongest players in the game, they needed an intelligent strategy to overcome their tough opponents. Team member Oh Il-nam is full of helpful hints that his allies use to excellent effect.
기죽지들 마라. 줄다리 일은 힘으로만 하는 게 아니야.
Unfortunately, his old tricks aren't enough to secure the victory. When the team is close to falling to their doom, Sang-woo makes the bonkers suggestion that they should all move closer to the edge.
내가 신호하면 딱 세 발만 앞으로 가는 거야!
앞으로 가라고? 미쳤어!
This risky move throws their opponents off balance and allows the team to make an epic comeback. Sang-woo's genius tug-of-war strategy gave us the best and most brilliant game ending in the series.
그리고 오빠, 앞으로 딱 세 발만 가는 거야! 뭐야, 완전 멋진 표정!
Do you agree with our picks? Check out this other recent clip from WatchMojo. And be sure to subscribe and ring the bell to be notified about our latest videos.